Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh to Dr. Ali. My name is Nurul Izzati binti Zaidin, and for today I will be presenting to you my proposal defense. Now, the topic that I've chosen is MS2B tests a student's perception on using SmartBoard in English classroom. So, the research background. Preston and Mowbray 2008 defined SmartBoard as a brand of interactive whiteboard in which displaying the image from the computer monitor with the surface operating as a giant touchscreen. In Malaysia, SmartBoards in education can be tracked back to past Smart School program in the year of 2000, where Malaysia's Prime Minister of Education at the time endeavored to install SmartBoard in all selected schools. In terms of education, Glover and Miller were the ones who did research on SmartBoards in classroom. Now for the introduction. A simple definition of SmartBoard. A SmartBoard is the computer system that is connected to the data projector, a board and other related tools that present and depicts educational contents with its multimedia features to the students in an interactive and collaborative. This is stated by Ahmad et al. In 2017. Hence, this research is to study the perception towards using SmartBoards in English classroom. Now there's three literature review here. So the first literature review is the perception of teachers towards SmartBoard technology in a Malaysian primary school. This is done by Hyung Song Shao, Daniel Isaac bin Zainuddin, Seo Leong Ling, Lee Min Eng, and Zhao Qiyang. Now the purpose of this study is to investigate the perception of Malaysian teachers on the technology in general. The research focuses on SmartBoards. Data was collected by means of structured questions in line with a short interview form of open-minded question techniques. Questionnaire composed of different section and multiple choice question. 5-point Likert scale on a 1 to 5 agree to disagree response. All in all, the findings of this research states that it is potentially support the use of SmartBoard in classroom and contribute towards the various learning activities and strategies using SmartBoard. Second literature review is primary school teachers' perception on the integration of interactive whiteboard, IWB, during reading instruction by Karmini Karthigesu and Maslawati Muhammad. So now this article aims to explore the perception of teachers on the integration of an interactive whiteboard, IWB, in reading comprehension lesson and how it could be implemented effectively in ESL classroom. Qualitative case study was carried out among 6 ESL teachers, and 6 pupils were chosen through purposive sampling. Overall, the research finds that teachers have positive perception towards integrating IWB in ESL reading lessons, such as increase in concentration, engagement, and motivation to read. The integration of IWB was found to satisfy pupils' multiple intelligence with the implementation of various features. Now lastly, the article that I had reviewed is the effect of using SmartBoard on improving 9th grade female students' English writing skills in Southern Al-Mazar Directorate Education by Rafa Awad Abdul Al-Salam Al-Tarawneh. So the aim of this research is to investigate the effect of using SmartBoards in improving English writing skills for girls in Southern Mazarita School District during the first semester of 2017 and 2018. The research employed a pretest and a protest to evaluate the students' writing skills. The group of 67 female students were randomly chosen to participate in the analysis. Overall, the finding states that the SmartBoard approach should be applied in the education phase in the classroom. Additionally, they state that they could educate teachers on how to utilize SmartBoards and motivate them to apply them in instructional phase. Now, what are the significance of this research? Well, the significance of this study is to widen the existing research about SmartBoards usage in English classroom among bachelor students. So what is the problem statement? Based on the first article that I have read before, in the light of research results, future research shall look into actual experiments on pedagogical SmartBoard and that take a longer period of time on Malaysian teachers of different qualifications, genders, and years of teaching experiences. The research population and relevant demographic, which is a limitation in the present research, should be augmented in order to produce healthier analysis in research. This was stated before in the first article that I have reviewed. Now, there's two research objectives. So the first research objective is to determine MS2B test the students' perception in using SmartBoards in English classroom. And secondly, to identify MS2B test the students' perception on advantages in using smart boards in English classroom. Now there's also two research questions. So the first research question is asking, what are MSUB test students' perception on using smart boards in English classroom? And the second one is, what are MSUB test students' perception on the advantages of using smart boards in English classroom? So this is my conceptual framework. My conceptual framework has both independent variable and dependent variable. So the independent variable is MSUB test students' perception, and the dependent variable is using smart board in English classroom. So these are the most methodology of my research. Now for the research design, I'll be using quantitative method, and the participants are MSUB test students. Sampling methods are simple random methods. The instruments are survey online questionnaires. Data collection procedure is by distributing the questionnaire through online platforms such as WhatsApp. Data analysis procedure is by I'll be using SPSS software. So these are the references of the articles. And this is the appendix. These are one of the two of the articles that I've chosen, and this one as well. Also, this is the timeline for the research. So you see, this is like the gist of the timeline, which is planning, preparation, analysis, proposal defense, conducting, review, and launch. The launch will be on January 2022. The planning will be on February 2021, preparation in April 2021, analysis in May 2021, review in August 2021, and then launch in January 2022. That's all for me for today. This is my proposal defense. Thank you, Dr. Ali, for listening and for looking at my literature review and also my proposal defense. Thank you so much and goodbye.